Welcome to the sixth week of the Powering Agriculture MOOC on Sustainable Energy for Food. Within that initiative, USAID, the governments of Sweden and Germany, as well as Duke Energy and OPIC, promote clean energy solutions in the agriculture and food sector. For the MOOC, the partners are cooperating with TH Kim, a university of applied science based in Cologne, Germany.
Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Powering Agriculture Massive Open Online Course on Sustainable Energy for Food. Today we are in the sixth week of our course. The topic for this week is energy and agriculture on micro level, and I am Stefania Bracco from the UN Food and Agriculture Organization in Rome. As you know, energy is an essential input throughout the agri-food chain. And sustainable energy interventions, such as renewable energy technologies and energy efficiency options, can be adopted by small and medium farmers, as well as by large agri-food businesses. This lecture is meant to help you in assessing whether a specific energy investment is a good deal or not. Obviously, this decision depends on many aspects. Therefore, today we will discuss a reliable methodology to evaluate the sustainability and profitability of a project. The content for this week is structured in two parts. First, we will see the different scales of agri-food enterprises, which show differences in management and incorporation of renewables, since they adopt diverse energy inputs and have different capital availability. In the second part, we will describe the investment planning for sustainable energy interventions in agricultural and food enterprises. You will learn how to perform a cost-benefit analysis on energy investment, and some tools for small agri-food businesses will be provided. Let's then start by analyzing the scale of enterprises. Operators in agri-food value chain range from basic subsistence smallholder farmers growing food from their consumption to family farms and small businesses, for which different energy options exist depending on the degree of modernization, up to large commercial corporate farms supplying huge supermarket chains across the world. These farm systems vary accordingly to their dependence on energy and energy sources, and they show different capacities for investing in and managing renewables. For instance, large corporate businesses have access to finance for capital investment. Therefore, they have large potential to substitute fossil fuels with renewable energy sources and to invest in energy efficiency options for production or processing activities, such as solar or wind irrigation systems, solar refrigeration, geothermal drying, and so on. Still, coordinated networks of subsistence farmers and small farmers and businesses can also benefit from sustainable energy systems, such as, for instance, solar heat for crop drying, on-farm produced biogas for cooking, or electricity generated from a solar photovoltaic system. By looking at the recommended reading material for this week, you can learn more details about the classification of agro enterprises and their potential for sustainable energy solutions. Let us now move to present the necessary steps to plan investment and to analyze feasibility and financial and economic costs and benefits related to sustainable energy intervention along agri-food chains. When planning an investment in renewable or energy-efficient technologies, the farmer or project manager should first perform a feasibility analysis. This is an analysis of the ability to complete a project successfully, taking into account economic, institutional, social, and technical factors. A feasibility study allows to investigate the possible negative and positive outcomes of a project before investing too much time and money. The financial and economic cost-benefit analysis of an investment in sustainable energy solutions is instead comparing the incremental costs and benefits of the project in order to assess whether all actors have enough incentive to participate in it. A cost-benefit analysis, so-called CBA, requires a comparison between the potential situation with and without the project. So the first step in a CBA is the identification and description of both the benchmark or reference scenario, which normally consists in fossil fuel power technologies, and the renewable energy scenario, where the technology is adopted. The second step is the identification of the investment outcomes, including the capital and operating costs of the technology and the monetized benefits. Since costs and benefits do not occur at the same time, as costs generally precede and exceed benefits during the initial years of the project, the comparison requires discounting techniques. The third step in a CBA is the determination of the project's incremental net flow, financial and economic, which results from comparing costs and benefits of the project with the benchmark scenario. With all these elements, is it possible to calculate the corresponding project profitability indicator? In general, a cost-benefit analysis provides four main profitability indicators. The net present value, NPV, showing the monetary value of the project's net benefit over its lifetime. The internal rate of return, IRR, which is the discount rate at which the net present value of the cost equals the net present value of the benefits. The benefit-cost ratio, the ratio between discounted benefits and discounted total costs associated with the energy intervention. And the payback time, which indicates the number of years required for the discounted sum of benefits to equal the discounted investment cost. All these indicators and terms will be explained in more detail in the provided reader material. In financial analysis, all costs and benefits are valued at market prices, since the main goal is to examine the financial returns to project stakeholders. Financial analysis is so undertaken from the point of view of the individual agent performing the investment. Instead, economic analysis is undertaken from the perspective of the overall economic system, and it deals with the costs and benefits to society. The main differences between financial and economic analysis are three. First, the economic analysis attempts to quantify externalities, such as greenhouse gas emissions, water savings, and other environmental and social impacts resulting from the project. Second, the economic analysis removes transfer payments such as fossil fuel subsidies and taxes. And third, the economic analysis makes use of shadow prices that eliminate market distortion and reflect the effective opportunity costs for the economy. We have introduced the CBA methodology very shortly here. I hope this lecture helped you to get a general overview on how to perform a micro-assessment of investment in sustainable energy solutions. You can go through the lecture materials to learn more details, and you will find there tools and a case study that will help you understanding this topic better. In fact, several online tools are available to support small and medium businesses in performing cost-benefit evaluation of their investment in an energy food context. The reader documents will link you to some of them. Thank you for your attention and good luck with the quiz.
Thank you for your attention and see you next week.